So the fourth one might actually be the easiest to get going. So this is the New World screwworm, which has the amazing scientific name of Cochleomyia hominivorax, the man devourer. But it doesn't primarily eat humans. It feeds indiscriminately on warm-blooded things, so mammals and birds. And it is a bot fly that lays its eggs in open wounds, anything as small as a tick bite. And it's called the screwworm because the larvae are screw-shaped, and they drill their way into living flesh, devouring it. And we know that it's horrendously painful because people get affected by this. And the standard of treatment is you give them morphine immediately so that surgeons can cut the things out, because it's just that painful. It's unbelievably agonizing. So 1 billion animals are devoured alive by flesh-eating maggots every single year. We even know that we can eradicate this species from at least many ecosystems and not see any effects because it used to be present in North America too. And we wiped it out. American taxpayer dollars today contribute to the creation and maintenance of a living wall of sterile screwworm flies released in southern Panama that prevents the South American screwworm from reinvading North America. But there's too many of them in South America to wipe out by that means. And so the way forward is obviously gene drive. Uruguay suffers, they lose about 0.1% of their total country's GDP to the screwworm. But from an animal well-being perspective, in addition to the human development, typical lifetime of an insect species is several million years. So 10 to the sixth years times 10 to the ninth hosts per year means an expected 10 to the 15th mammals and birds devoured alive by flesh-eating maggots. For comparison, if we continue factory farming for another 100 years, that would be 10 to the 13th broiler hens and pigs. So unless it's 100 times worse to be a factory farmed broiler hen than it is to be devoured alive by flesh-eating maggots, then when you integrate over the future, it is more important for animal well-being that we eradicate the New World screwworm from the wild than it is that we end factory farming tomorrow.